Hello everyone. So in our previous video, we saw that we were dealing with the cash flows of ITC, where we plotted the net increase and decrease in the cash and cash equivalents, where we demarcated the positive values in green and the negative values in red. Also, we edited the chart a bit to look really neat and presentable. In this class, we'll show that as to how we can highlight the maximum value or the highest value in a different color. To do so, let me just go back to my previous day's chart, which is over here. Now, what we can simply do is we can select this particular bar by double clicking and we can change the color from here. But what will happen is that if you do this, it will not make your chart more dynamic. Why so? Because if your highest value changes, then this will remain in the dark green color or whatever color you want to give. But the highest value now will not have the color you wanted to have. So in that case, we want to create a dynamic chart so that if the highest value changes, my value over here, my chart over here will also adjust itself. For that, we'll create a new chart which we'll superimpose on our existing one. So for that, I'll write an if statement. We'll start with the very simple if statement. If this is equal to our maximum of the entire column, I'll just click on F4 to make this absolute. Value is true, obviously we want this particular value, otherwise we just want it to be blank. Once this is done, I will drag this down and we have 84.07 as the highest value which has been highlighted. So now what we'll do, we'll simply add this to our existing chart. We'll just simply right click anywhere in the chart area and select data. We'll add the new series. Let the series name be blank because that is not required. I will simply select this entire column, click on OK, and we have the data pasted on top of our existing chart. So we have this only one bar because the other are blanks. So we have only one bar which is in yellow in color. But do we want like this? No, we want the both bars to overlap on each other so that whatever the color you give to this particular bar will be represented and will be shown as the highest value. To do that, we'll just simply click on this orange bar which I've got, right click, click on format series, format data series. In that, in the series options, there is something as series overlap. Over here, it's 0% because there is no overlap between the two series which you see. This was the first series and this was the second series which I've currently plotted. To exactly overlap both, we'll increase this to 100%. Once we do so, you can see both the series have been overlapped and you can now give your own color. And I'll just give it a simple dark green color to represent it as the highest value. And this is it. You have your graph ready. Simple and very efficient to show different types of data which you have. Now suppose if I change my maximum value, let me just, instead of using the formula, let me just type in and see if this works out. So I'll just change this to 100 maybe. And the moment I do so, you can see, the moment I change the highest value over here changes and we have the dark green color for March 19, which represents the highest value. So this is how you can create your charts dynamically to show different representation for the positive negative values and to highlight the maximum values. You can also highlight the minimum values, or you can highlight the values if you want to highlight any average values. Also, those can be done by simple use of your if statement and a basic features of your chart. Thank you. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If yes, please like our channel. Thank you.